Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. It's Agnes at MomCanDoIt.com. You're probably watching this video because either you're about to begin a CCA journey or you're already on it. And I wanted to tell you or share with you my journey on ACCA. For those that don't know, ACCA stands for Association of Chartered Certified Accountants, and I have been qualified as an ACCA accountant from July 2019. This is when I gained my qualifications. But the journey to become a qualified accountant was a long one. So I just wanted to share with you my experiences from the time that I've signed up to be an ACCA student to the time that I've received this qualification. So from the time that I signed up to be an ACCA qualified accountant, I have had 6 fails, 5 passes, and 1 missed exams. Now you're wondering why only so little. This is because I have actually finished university where I have gained 9 exemptions. And somebody would think, oh, that's easy, right? Because you've already had 9 exemptions. But obviously to gain those exemptions, I had to go to university. And the university that I've signed up to have had followed ACCA structure, which means that the minute I set the exam with the university, it was already giving me exemption because it was following exact same structure of exams that ACCA follows. So you probably know that ACCA is a globally recognized professional body for accountants, and it is recognized everywhere. And having this qualification truly opens a lot of doors. You can become anyone from accountant, financial director, CFO, CEO, or even run your own company. 20% of CEOs is qualified accountants, and 50% has got some kind of financial background. Being an accountant truly opens up the door to a big career. At this point in time, I'm financial controller, and having children limits me a little bit as to how quick I can progress in my career. I'm not complaining, just being honest here. However, as soon as you're qualified as an accountant, you really do have a lot of doors opening up to you. But the journey to become a qualified accountant is definitely not an easy one. And this is why I wanted to tell you a bit more about my journey and to also let you know that although it's not an easy and it's not a quick journey, it is definitely worth taking. So first sign up to an ACCA as a student was in December 2012. This is when I have registered my name that I was interested to complete my qualification. So this is when I actually signed up to be a student. That's 2012. When I actually got my qualification was in July 2019. So you probably think, what happened in 7 years? It took me 7 years from the time I decided that I want to do ACCA to the time that I've actually got my qualification. And yes, it was a very, very long time. I did not actually sit my first successful exam up until December 2015. So it took me 3 years from the time that I registered to the time that I've actually sat my first exam. This is only because I was looking around for an employer that will sign me up to study with either BPP or Kaplan to be able to go to lessons and just study there so that it's easier for me to pass and understand what I'm actually learning about. But I didn't know I can actually self-study ACCA only if I find the right resources. So keep watching till the end because I will give you a little bit of insight of which resources I used that did lead me to passing all my papers. So the first time that I found a job that has offered that within my contract they will support me or they will sponsor my lessons towards my qualification was in 2015, where I have found BPP provider to go and study with them. And I must say that BPP did not impress me. I sat P2 at that time, which was then known as corporate reporting. Now also what I want to mention, that at the time that I was still studying, there was 5 professional papers. So these are the only papers that I had to do, the professional ones. And when I signed up to ACCA, at that point you had to do 5 exams. Nowadays there is only 4 because they have combined P1 and P3 into SBL, which is known as Strategic Business Leadership. So I have had an exemption from that as well, because by passing P1 and P3, they've combined this together and I didn't have to sit this exam the minute that the change happened. So I did sit 5 exams, which some might think it was harder, some might think it was easier, because I do think sitting a little bit longer exam maybe a bit more difficult because it's all cramped into one paper. But the papers were relatively easy and they were not so much number focused. So the first exam that I sat with BPP was a P2, as I mentioned already, and I have failed this exam. My first fail was obviously very you know, discouraging, and every single fail that I've had was very discouraging. And as I did mention, I had 6 fails, so I have really been, you know, not having a good luck on those exams. But professional exams are really, really tough. And at the time that I was studying those professional exams, I had 2 children at first, then 3 already. And also, at some point in time, I had full-time jobs, or if not, I was on maternity leave. So, and having 3 children at home. So having all those responsibilities, it really means that you have very little time to study, and you really have to get yourself together, focus, study every single time that you can, and make sure that you pass those exams. And this was what I was focused on, and I was trying to do as much as I could in the free time that I've had. And the free time meaning probably evenings and only weekends, where I could ask my husband to perhaps supervise the kids while I went and studied. It was really difficult times, and I must say that despite all the failures, despite all the motivation that I've suffered because of that, and all the anxieties and all the stress that goes with it, I must say that if it wasn't for my husband, I would not be sitting here today and talking to you about it, because truly it is my husband who kept on motivating me, and I'm here to support you. Keep on going, don't give up. And every time that I had the result that said fail, I really felt very, very sad, and I cried. You know, I think all of you do if you're listening to this video, and if you have had failed the exams before, I'm pretty sure you have felt similar way to what I did. I felt dismotivated, I felt tearful, you know, I cried for a few days, but then, do you know what, I had a few bits of rest, and after conversations with my husband and him motivating me to keep going, I just carried on. And up until I found a resource which was really good, I was kind of struggling through my ACC journey, and the fails kept coming. And even though I found this really good resource, I still managed to fail first exam. But this was only because those exams are really, really difficult, and they're not for anyone. And if they were easy, come on, we would have had everyone being an accountant, or anyone that thinks that accounts is easy, they would have gone and studied ACC and they would have become qualified accountant. Like, not everyone can be a doctor, same as not everyone can be an accountant. And if those was easy to do, everyone would go for it. Not everyone's cut out for it, and I believe that you have to have determination, and you need to be very motivated to become an accountant. So if I've managed to do it with 3 children, full-time job, career, and also having a household to run, then I'm pretty sure you can manage too. And this is the main message that I'm trying to produce to you. You know, you can do it no matter what the life circumstances are, no matter how bad your life is at the moment, no matter how many responsibilities you have, you can do it. And you're doing it to better your future, to better your family's future, to better whatever future you want to have for yourself. This is what you want to do. You want to qualify, because this truly opens up a whole lot of opportunities. Now, as I did mention before, I am a financial controller, but the minute I qualified, my salary went significantly up, and I did step in a higher role to what I was already. So straight away, I've had a bonus. And I know that the world is not ending at what I'm doing at the moment, and this is just the beginning. I'm just waiting for my children to grow up a little bit so I can allow myself to go and explore those opportunities. But the door is there for me. Having those qualifications already, I am geared up for the roles and for the opportunities that are out there for me. So I really wanted to just pass this message to you to say, keep going, because it's all worth it. You will get there one day, I promise you. It is a difficult journey, but every time you feel dismotivated, please put this video on, because I am hoping that you get the message. It is all possible and it's all doable. You can reach your potentials because you got it in you. It's just tough at the beginning and it gets harder as you go, but you will get there, I promise you. So I did mention before that there were resources that I reached eventually, and I found out that they were the best, and I swear, the best out there. And I'm not working with this person, or I'm not working with the company that I'm going to mention to you. And as much as I have got to know the tutor that runs this place, I did never got paid, or I did never get told to promote this website. So the source that I'm telling you about is called Accountancy, like a cow, because this guy, Richard Clark, who is a founder and who is the tutor in accountancy, wanted to make accountancy fun. He wanted to make sure that accountancy doesn't have to be boring and studying towards your professional qualification can have a little bit of fun in it. So he developed a model which is called Accountancy, and he's got a very funky looking cows helping us along the way to study. It sounds a little bit silly, but that's what he wanted to achieve. He wanted to achieve a little bit of silliness in the whole seriousness of a matter. So if you do struggle on your journeys and you've never come across accountancy, I highly recommend you do check their website, because not only the courses are online based, which means you do it in your own pace, because I did find that actually having those lessons in my house played on demand made me more able to access them, because having busy life with full-time job and three children in the house was very difficult for me to come out there and go into the classes and sit face to face with the teacher, you know, for 8 hours straight. But with having this on demand, I could play it every single evening for a couple of hours, and this really did help me to pass through my exams. So yes, as I mentioned, Richard is a fantastic tutor. He has been teaching before in BPP. He's got a Facebook page as well, and there is lots of students there signing up every single day. Every so often he greets another 100, another 200 people joining in the community, because he truly is the best in the field. And he's recently been approved by ACCA as well, which means that even ACCA recognizes his work. So yes, I really recommend accountancy. If you have asked me what resources should I use to study ACCA, 100% hand on heart accountancy. So that is all, guys. My journey, as I said, did last a very long time. It does sound a lot, but I did have some gaps in between, I did have some fails in between, and you know, life happens for every one of us. But it is so much easier now. That back in the days was only 2 exams per year, now you can sit 4 times a year. That's not 4 exams, because in every session I believe you can sit up to 3 or 4 exams. I can't even remember that. I will double check that and put that on the screen below. But yes, you can sit 3 or 4 exams. I really wouldn't recommend unless you're really rushing and you have plenty of time in hand, because it is very difficult. I have followed the route of doing 1 exam per sitting, and even that I've managed to fail 6 times. So it is really difficult. You want to focus, really focus on that one paper and master it and practice your past papers as much as possible so that you pass. And I really would like to hear from you. What stage are you on? Are you starting your ACCA journey, or are you at the end of your ACCA journey, or are you in between? Tell me how many papers you got left, and I really am here to support you and motivate you and inspire you, because I've done it and you can do it too. And I really hope and I really wish that you do well on your ACCA journey. If you have any specific questions about ACCA, I'm not a tutor, I'm not teaching, I forgot half the things that I've learned probably, but if you do want to help in terms of how did I study, how did I self-study, I will be covering much more in my videos. And also I have a blog called mumcandoit.com. I will post that link below. But as I mentioned, in this channel I will be talking more about ACCA journey, ACCA resources, self-study, and all the other questions you might guys have. So I really hope you find this helpful, informative and motivational, because I really really think that we can all do it. Whoever is already on ACCA journey, they have signed up to something very, very big and very important, and I believe you can all do it. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Please give me a thumbs up, don't forget to subscribe, and any questions you have, please don't forget to leave them down below in the comments. Thank you so much, and I hope to see you soon. Take care.